Hey, welcome to NASA Edge.
An inside and outside look
at all things NASA.
Oh, that's going to leave a mark.
We're here with Dr. Carlos Calle, and we're talking about the dust mitigation system. Now, I worked with your teammates out at Desert Rats where they explained the dust mitigation system, but apparently there's a lot more to the system that I didn't know. So kind of explain to me what you do here.
We've been working with this technology for 7 years now, and we started to develop a way to remove dust from solar panels on Mars. Mars being a dusty planet, there's a big problem with dust accumulating on solar panels, and so that was our first approach to this technology. And so let me show you actually
what are some examples?
Some examples, like... The one that we tested at Desert Rats, we have two panels here.
Okay.
To demonstrate that we could remove dust from the windows that we attached to the door, as you remember, out there at Desert Rats, to demonstrate that we can maintain that hatch clean so that when the rovers mate with the habitats, before the doors are open, we need to clean these things before, so that we don't have dust in the habitat. This particular type of panel contains two sets of electrodes, which are like sets of fingers interlaced, and we apply a signal which is out of phase. And so we apply the signal to this electrode and then to that one, then back to this, and then to this. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
And the reason you do that is if you just sent the signal once, it would lift the dust, but then the dust would settle back down.
Right back down, exactly. And so this is the way to make it walk. One that we developed to protect optical systems, camera lenses,
it's just and a so on. Piece of glass?
And it's a piece of glass, but it has transparent electrodes, which have a different configuration. We have three of those. In this particular case, when we wrap them around in a circle like that, then we have an electric field that radiates out.
Gotcha.
And so it's like ripples on a pond.
Right, because otherwise you could create pockets that where the dust wouldn't move.
Right.
So you kind of have to work that way.
So I have the same panel that I showed you earlier down here in this box.
Oh, so you have an example.
So we have a brush that we use to deliver the dust to simulate exploration activities on the moon that would kick up dust. So I'm adding actually a lot of dust.
You are adding a lot of dust. I'm feeling uncomfortable, like you're besmirching the test article. And have you ever added too much and been unsuccessful with your test?
Actually, yes. if you pile it up. I mean, actually, it works eventually.
Over time, okay, it takes a little longer. Now you're going to just throw a switch?
So I'm going to throw a switch and activate the three electrodes.
Oh, wow.
And so it throws dust to the periphery of the where the electrode.
It looks computer generated. I mean, and oddly, it seemed to work inward. So there's not a lot of carryover. You know, once they get away from the electrodes, dust settles again.
Yeah.
Now, what would happen if you drop dust now?
We can do that.
Really?
We can do that.
Are you sure?
We keep it running, and we can drop dust on it, and we'll see what happens. It actually deflects it.
It won't stay on.
As a shield. And so we pelt it.
Even if you drop
large amounts of it, it just deflects it.
Well, why do you need to do more testing? Because this looks 100% successful in my untrained eye.
It is very successful, but it is at a small scale still. For Desert Rats, we scale it up to this configuration, an 8x10 and a 9-inch diameter. A circular panel for the window. This year, we're going to try to see if we can cover the entire hatch, which is about a 2.5 by 4 feet door.
One other rumor, and you can either confirm or deny that this is true. One thought is you'd like to incorporate this technology even within clothing, i.e. a spacesuit.
Right.
Is that true?
We have done some work.
Okay. This is
actually a piece of cotton, and the electrodes are made of carbon nanotube ink that was actually developed in our polymers lab here at KSC.
Wow.
We tested these in air and at vacuum successfully.
Awesome.
And so the next step, of course, is to go from cotton to a more representative material for spacesuits. And that is the challenge.
If this technology works, maybe they can reconsider like cotton dockers up there in space. 100% cotton dockers. As a matter of fact, I'd like a pair of cotton dockers with this on. I'd be really hip and dust free. Well, very good. Thanks so much for your time.
My pleasure.
You're watching NASA Edge, an inside and outside look at all things NASA, completely dust free.
There we go.
Thank you very much. I appreciate
it.
This is awesome. I can't believe you can keep the dust off there perpetually. It's great.